Casamayor. And you can see that Casamayor is already 31 years old. He was well into his 20s before he defected to the United States from Cuba. Height equal, reach just about equal. They both weighed in within 3 pounds of the 130-pound limit. Casamayor unofficially on her HBO scale tonight, already up to 141. Campbell, 135. Rules of the bout with her unofficial ringside scorer, Harold Lederman.
The Joel Casamayor-Nate Campbell fight is scheduled for 10 rounds using the rules of the California State Athletic Commission. There is no three-knockdown rule. The doctor or the referee can stop the fight. In case the cut is caused by an accidental headbutt, we go to the scorecards after the fourth round has begun, and you can be saved by the bell in the 10th and final round only. Jim.
All right, here's a quick look at Joel Casamayor. He says, why in the world would somebody like Campbell think that he's ready to fight somebody like me?
Casamayor is the best fighter that emerged from Cuba among all those fighters who came to America. He came, he says, because after winning a gold medal in 1992 and about to go in the Olympics in 1996, he was promised by the Cuban government that he'd get a house and a car for all his efforts in behalf of the country and all he sacrificed. He said all they gave him was a bicycle. America, here I come.
And why do you come to America? We'll take a look at Nate Campbell. 3 years ago, he was stocking grocery store shelves for Winn-Dixie. Co-worker told him you ought to box. Tonight, he makes $150,000, six times as much as he's ever made for any of his previous 23 prize fights.
You can't make a Nate Campbell up. Let's see if he can make himself up even better than we have seen before.
And let's go to ring announcer Michael Buffer now for the official introductions.
Ladies and gentlemen, good evening and welcome to the Pechanga Resort and Casino here in Temecula, California, where tonight, DiBella Entertainment is proud to present an evening of professional boxing, brought to you in association with your King of Beers, Budweiser, and HBO Sports, sanctioned by the California State Athletic Commission. This first bout is presented along with Cedric Kushner Promotions with Team Freedom and Main Events. This event tonight is dedicated to the memory of the late Larry Rosadilla. The three judges at ringside scoring this contest will be Jerry Cantu, Chuck Hassett, and David Mendoza. And when the bell rings, your referee in charge of the action, Pat Russell. And now, ladies and gentlemen, 10 rounds of boxing between two of the very best junior lightweights in the world. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing blue with white and officially weighing 131 pounds. His professional record is a perfect one, 23 bouts, 23 victories, including 21 knockouts. From Jacksonville, Florida, here is the undefeated Nate Galaxy Warrior Campbell. And his opponent across the ring, fighting out of the red corner, wearing black with gold, and his official weight is 133 pounds. He has an outstanding professional record consisting of 28 victories, including 18 knockouts with only one defeat. Originally from Cuba, now living and fighting out of Miami, Florida, ladies and gentlemen, the former WBA junior lightweight champion of the world, Joel El Cepillo Casamayor.
Okay, there's a line right there. There's a line right there. 10 rounds. Buena suerte. Good luck. Let's go.
Nate Campbell says that he will be on top of Casamayor from ding to dong. We shall see.
Casamayor had a chance to become the number one man in the division when he fought a title unification fight against Brazil's Asilino Freitas a year ago. There was a questionable knockdown which went against Casamayor. He was also penalized a point in the bout and wound up losing a two-point decision on all three cards. He looks back at the Freitas fight and believes he was robbed. Now he faces a climb to get back in the same position. Casamayor starting out jabbing to the body with that right hand.
Campbell off of speed in the fight. When you're fast, you can get away with a lot of mistakes, even inexperience.
It's a good point, George, because several weeks ago when we looked at Campbell on the undercard of Arturo Gatti versus Mickey Ward the second time, you said that from a technical standpoint, he didn't much like the way he was throwing his right hand. However, he's proud that he's knocking people out with it.
He's not a finish fighter. When I say a finish fighter, most fighters have gotten their right hand, left hand, even hooks together. He hasn't gotten all that together yet, but he's getting by with that speed. And he believes in himself.
Absolutely. That really is what Campbell says is the difference, is he's determined and he believes. And there's a hard right-hand shot up the pipe on Joel Casamayor's chin.
One of those right hands thrown, not perfect, but right on the button.
Let him go. Let him go. Stop. Break. You, stop. Come here. None of that. No elbow. Let's go.
Casamayor is trying to impose his strength on Campbell. That's what you got to do.
And perhaps his experience, too. I mean, if he can get away with a little foul here and there that says, I've been here and you haven't.
Stop.
Yeah, he's got a big chest for that weight class, Casamayor.
Well, trainer Joe Goosen is at great pains to tell us how strong Casamayor is. Could be another way of saying he's not as quick as he used to be.
Got big, strong legs. All of the things that can really intimidate a fighter once they get a little tired and see you on the opposite end of the ring over there.
Nate Campbell, I'm sure, would hop in here and claim to you, George, that he is intimidation proof. And as Larry pointed out before the fight, Campbell's seen the bottom. He's looking to get to the top.
Being a little bit more resourceful and cautious in this first round is Campbell to test what he's seeing, if it's something he's never seen before. If Casamayor is quicker and stronger, having been in the limelight ever since he was an amateur more than 10 years ago.
Time.
And when we go to Casamayor's corner, where his trainer Joe Goosen will speak some Spanish to him, our interpreter is Ray Torres.
The punch hard? You gotta move, okay?
Yeah.
Attack him nice and easy. You gotta, yes, you gotta jab him to the arms, all over the shoulders.
Watch the elbow.
Drop something down to the body. Okay?
Tell him about the elbow. Make sure your fighter doesn't remember this hit.
Okay, nice and relaxed. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. Keep shooting the right hands here. Everything to the chest. Okay, you got him where you want him. You got him where you want him. Keep him there. Stay focused. Remember what I told you. 1 hour, baby.
1 hour, okay?
Best punch of that round, a straight right hand from Campbell. Last time we saw him, he was throwing looping right hands.
Smile.
Buddy McGirt has been helping him.
Well, Buddy McGirt is a hot, celebrated trainer in the sport right now as the result of the work he's done in bringing back Arturo Gatti's boxing skills. McGirt has gotten a ton of attention and a brand new contract with Main Events to train all of their fighters. Tremendous compliment to Buddy for what he's accomplished in his brief tour of duty as a trainer since having retired as a fighter himself. Shot by Campbell.
Let it go.
Misses over the top with the right hand, but after an extremely cautious first round in which Campbell only threw 34 punches, now he looks like he's ready to get aggressive. That could create some opportunities for Casamayor.
Casamayor, he's letting a lot of minutes go by and he hasn't touched Campbell's chest. He hasn't hit him on the shoulder. He hasn't touched him at all. He's allowing this guy to move in and out whenever he wants. These rounds goes by, he should be weakening Campbell, not allowing him to get back and set up whatever he wants.
Campbell complaining about some near head collisions. Son, this ain't no county meet. This is the big time.
There's going to be a lot of head butting because of the one, the southpaw.
Grip those hands. Don't pin him inside.
What's impressive about Campbell is, though he has some nice offensive things going for him, is that he keeps his hands up when he gets in punching range of Casamayor. Casamayor has not been able yet to find a hole in the defense.
And Casamayor walked into an up and under right hand shot thrown by Campbell. And there's another right hand thrown on the same arc.
Watch your hands, both of you.
That also lands, as do their heads, as they touch, and Pat Russell looks for damage. There is none.
What's happening is this guy is so dynamic, Campbell. There's movement going on, and unless you're in the ring, you can't see it. You want a guy to kind of be still for 1 second so you can land a shot. And that's what Casamayor is looking for. Just little
just
stationary
like
there.
Remember the English fighter, Paul Engle. His whole body twitches from toe to head as he fights. Campbell's got a little of that in him. There's just enough wiggle there to throw you off.
Just enough to just make you hold back that shot you were going to throw.
Normally, with a fighter as raw and inexperienced as Campbell, oh, there's a hard right-hand counter shot as Casamayor, making a rookie mistake, dropped his lead hand. Normally, a fighter like Campbell has to be schooled on defense. He says Buddy McGirt is mostly working with him on his offense.
You got to get him to punch. You got to get closer. Closer. Mira por su...
Okay, watch for his uppercut. He's throwing that at you.
Yeah,
the right uppercut is coming in. You watch above and the jab.
The left hand. Okay, so keep sticking that left, sticking that left. Okay, let's start finding the range with the jab.
Okay.
All right, let's back him up a little bit this round. The next round we'll go to what we do best. Okay? Get a little more respect from him this round.
Get your stool, bud.
Work that jab, baby.
Here's the collision. Not unusual for that slight a collision to cause a cut. So far, we haven't seen anything like that.
So far in the fight, by CompuBox estimate, Casamayor's landed only 5 of 39 jabs. An effective technical boxer. He probably expected to be more accurate in landing
free
his
hands,
jab.
Free hands, free him up. Don't need me. Let that head go. Let it go. Let that head go.
Increasingly, Campbell is turning this into a brawl and to his great advantage.
Let that head go. Let it go. Let that head go. Stop punching. All right, I got to stop. Stop. Break. Step out. Free hands. Free him up. No elbows.
That's the best way to fight a tiger is to attack him. If you don't run, sometimes they won't attack. If you attack them now, as Campbell is doing.
No cabeza.
He's jumping on the puncher.
No elbow.
Well, I guarantee you, Campbell doesn't think that Casamayor is the puncher in the fight. When he fought Daniel Alisea, our Harold Letterman mentioned that he thought Alisea was a bigger puncher than Campbell, and Campbell was still talking about it yesterday. He's incensed.
He's making a bad mistake because this is the only way that Casamayor can get in the fight when the things get close like that. You don't want to get close with a guy who hasn't been able to touch you all night.
Campbell tagging Casamayor with a straight right hand and then popping his chin upward with an uppercut.
No punch.
And there's an abrasion on the left chin and a little bit of a blood of Casamayor.
Again, the right hand lands up the pipe. Casamayor starting to try to double and triple the jab, but Campbell coming right back at him.
Normally, Casamayor is a very well-schooled pinpoint counterpuncher. He hasn't been able to do that in this fight so far.
Let his head out. Let it out. Stop.
All of these wrestling moments where Casamayor is holding and grabbing, this wears and tears on Campbell because of his real thin body type.
Let it go.
Lands a hard right hand shot to the body.
No
Casamayor with a couple of blows upstairs.
No.
I'm confused, George. you think that Campbell makes a big mistake by going right in close to Casamayor. Shouldn't Casamayor want to make this a boxing match, though, with his greater experience?
No, this guy's able to move. Campbell is able to hit and get out of the way. All night he can do this. You would beg to get a little closer so he doesn't get out of the way, especially if he hits you.
Gotcha.
So keep the fight close if you Casamayor.
There was a good moment for Casamayor.
I got it.
He rolled with a right hand.
That's right. Just go back.
Campbell and delivered a 1-2.
Able to do it because things are getting closer.
Time, corners.
There's an abrasion under the left eye of Joel Casamayor, right on his cheek.
Hey.
It's nothing.
Yes.
Hey, when you get him on the ropes, work on it. Yes. You keep your head on top of his and work on it. He doesn't want you to hit him. He's going to hold you.
Put your elbows on the tap, okay?
Pat, let me just say something real quick.
And what's
the guy's bowling into his head.
I know.
And he's using his
forearms. Fuck out of here. Here you see Campbell, who's the aggressor. Campbell is a young man who wants something that Casamayor has. Casamayor is defending something it's taken him years and years to build on. A reputation as one of the best fighters in the game.
And I don't know about you guys, but I see a look in Casamayor's eyes that tells me that Campbell is a much tougher nut to crack than he expected. Harold Lederman, how do you have it through three?
Okay, Jim, 3-0, 30-27, Nate Campbell. Jimmy, he's just winning this fight on effective aggressiveness. Well, not effective aggressiveness, but good ring generalship. He's moving to the right and setting up that straight right hand. He's landing a straight right hand all night, landing the good punches. 3-0, Nate Campbell.
I think the fight could be getting in Casamayor's favor now because Campbell is able to get his back on the ropes every now and then. This is what you want a speedy guy to do. Let his back stay on the ropes a few times.
Don't go back in.
He can't get out of the way when his back is on the rope.
Now Casamayor countering with the left hand and effectively so after Campbell overcommitted with his right.
Second time his back is getting closer and closer to those ropes, Campbell's back.
Campbell moves back, and then as Casamayor starts to come forward, Campbell jumps in to try to fire that straight right hand.
I want you to know that jumping back can cost you because that takes a lot of energy. He's got him on the rope.
No. Stop. Right. Good. Very good.
And you're supposed to step behind the referee and keep him right back
heads,
on the rope.
Watch your heads. No heads. Stop. Stop. You. Pick up your head up. Let's go. Right.
Casamayor not using his feet to put Campbell in a defensive position.
Now the body punches get in by Casamayor.
Hands. Free him up. Free him up,
this is far and away Casamayor's best round.
Whoa. Watch your
hands.
Go ahead.
For the moment, he seems to have solved the offensive puzzle of Campbell. He has deflated that straight right hand.
That right hand has not been straight. He's a southpaw and he's able to throw it because he moves in a direction. It hasn't gone straight at all.
Okay, then shall I call it the looping right hand?
Yeah, and it's good for a southpaw when you're fighting.
Step back, watch your hands.
It doesn't quite make the turn. If he ever turns it over, he'll drop Casamayor.
Punch combination by Casamayor drives Campbell back into the rope.
Ooh,
Campbell
good body
wants
shot.
To answer back and does hands. It with that hands. Right hand of the body.
Those hands go. Let them go. Stop. Break. Step back.
Casamayor is wanting to get it close, but he's paying a big price. This guy hits hard. Curved that right hand in there real good that time.
Campbell with Campbell a right down. Hand comeback in the last minute of round
right,
number
back,
four.
Watch your heads. Time. Corner.
HBO's acclaimed documentary series, Sports of the 20th Century, returns Monday, February 24, with Jim McKay, My World in My Words. This unique film, written and narrated by McKay himself, looks back at the life and achievements of this legendary broadcaster. host of the very first Wide World of Sports presentation in April 1961. McKay has covered 12 Olympics and is recognized as one of the most important and respected sports journalists ever.
He had just the right words and just the right line and just the right timing to be able to make you fully appreciate what you had just seen as something truly remarkable.
Thank you, Jackie Stewart. Jim McKay, My World in My Words, premieres Monday, Feb 24, only on HBO. CompuBox numbers in round four. Casamayor, 17 out of 62, by far his best round numerically. He also looked more comfortable in the fight than before. Campbell, 13 out of 45.
Hey, fix this corner.
The mark of a good pro is being able to figure out what your opponent is doing, what his rhythm is. Casamayor appeared to do that in the last round. Now let's see if Campbell can counter that.
Let the head go, let it go. Don't let that head, don't hold that head, let that head go.
So the first momentum shift in the fight seemed to come in round four as Casamayor finally weathered the early physical storm of Nate Campbell and began to pay him back for some of the punishment he'd taken in the first three rounds. Now we'll see if Campbell can find an adjustment that will put Casamayor back on the defensive.
All of this pushing and shoving and all of this works for Casamayor because he's got the big strong shoulders up there.
Hard right hand by Casamayor stuns Campbell as it knocks him into the corner.
You're holding, let him go.
Nate Campbell claiming to us yesterday that he's never actually been hurt in a fight. He may well have been hurt by that right hand shot. Campbell almost falling backward there as he delivered a right hand. Good left by Casamayor.
Casamayor has taken some punches very well and come right back at Campbell.
I think he's shown his professionalism by lowering his attack to the body, and that seems to have blunted Campbell's momentum.
The fight has gone on to the ropes now. It's no longer in the middle of the ring. Once the fight get closer to the ropes, it's Casamayor. That's what he wants, and that's when he can't miss. Campbell can't jump out of the way.
Needing an answer to the early aggression in round five, Campbell comes out and hits Casamayor in the mouth with the right hand. Casamayor takes the punch well and begins the combination punching assault again. Campbell totally on the defensive now as Joel Casamayor begins to find answers.
Campbell is a puncher, so Casamayor got to be a little careful. You just can't run into him just because he seems hurt and weak.
Campbell trying to load a right hand to blunt the Casamayor assault. Casamayor continues to deliver punches in bunches.
I can't understand why Casamayor is backing up now. He's got the man in the right position. Close in, keep it close.
Well, you talked about respecting a puncher with power, and Campbell has shown that he has it.
Back. Listen for the bell. Time!
Buddy McGirt seemed in a hurry to get into the corner that time. Obviously, he's got plenty to say to his fighter.
You hit him with beautiful right hands.
Wait to listen.
But you're not coming back with the hook. You're not coming back with the hook. You're throwing beautiful right hands, you're catching a whop, and you're waiting. So what he's doing, he's countering your right hand, okay? Give me some hooks this round.
Give me a deep breath.
Take a deep breath. Listen to me. You gotta start off with the hooks.
Okay.
You're throwing too many right hands. He's expecting that now. And what he's doing, when you throw it, he's countering with two shots. Let's go, baby.
Mix something up.
Faint that right hand.
You got him hurt. He's gonna quit. He doesn't want anything. He doesn't want anything else. You're gonna be champion again. You gotta let your hands go.
Yeah.
Let's see a right hand from Casamayor. Casamayor has been more of a two-handed puncher in this fight. As you heard Buddy McGirt say, he had Campbell, Casamayor figured Campbell out is just throwing that left jab and a right hand. He's got to start throwing some left hooks.
To prevent Casamayor from countering the right hand as effectively as he did in rounds four and five.
Only inside when they're shoulder to shoulder is Campbell throwing a left hook.
Now Casamayor has allowed Campbell to get a second wind there. He had him close to the rope, and he let him out the hook.
Hard right hand by Campbell.
Wanting the left hand shot by Casamayor. So a burst of energy here in the first minute of round six as Campbell tries to reestablish his initiative in the fight.
Campbell is bleeding also.
Blood coming from a nick above the right eye. Nate Campbell, and that blood is starting to trickle.
Stop, time!
And whereas Casamayor is damaged below the left eye.
You heard the referee is saying
cut by a butt.
Cut by a butt.
Yep.
Which means that if he had to stop this fight in this round, that we would go to the scorecards.
This being the last round in which that would happen.
Keep going. Fight your fight, son.
Casamayor was also cut above the right eye against Freitas. Right now, he's driving Campbell back again with straight punches, well delivered. Casamayor's jab was tentative in the first three rounds. He's thrown it with a lot more authority since he seemed to find a rhythm in the fight.
Casamayor is taking some punishment in the earlier rounds. That's why he can't seem to close in and finish this guy out. Campbell is ready to go. He's taking too much himself.
All right, I got it. Stop punching. Step back. Don't lean. Punches up. Lopez Arriba.
That Campbell is a little piece of leather, but he's well put together. That's one of the reasons that Casamayor can be aggressive. He keeps looking at this guy with a thin waist, and there's no reason to back up, he thinks. But these little punches that he throws, they hurt.
Free hands, free him up.
Well, it's become sort of a scratch and sniff affair for Nate Campbell as Joel Casamayor's greater professionalism has carried the day in the past three rounds. Coming up, Vernon Forrest will defend the World Welterweight Championship against a tough customer from Nicaragua named Ricardo Mayorga. Mayorga is the kind of guy who will have several beers tonight after the fight is over, win or lose. Celebrating the end of training, he'll probably light up a cigarette or two. But he is a dangerous puncher who says he's going to knock the Fighter of the Year for 2000, Vernon Forrest, out. There's Forrest warming up with Ronnie Shields. Good job on the pads, Ronnie.
Hey.
You've got to pressure this guy with jabs. You got to hit his body. Primero, no segundo, primero.
You got to be first. You got to be first. With.
Take a look and we'll see the headbutt. This time Campbell did not escape unmarked. You can see the medication over his right eye or alongside the right eye. It doesn't appear to be in a very dangerous place.
Campbell's cut man, Jim Waldrop, able to get the blood stopped during the between rounds period. Into the seventh of a schedule 10. Harold, how do you have it through six?
Okay, Jim, I thought that Joel Casamayor definitely pulled out the last three rounds. 3-3, 57-57. I got it all even, but all the momentum is with Casamayor. Certainly, he's figured out that Nate Campbell was just throwing right hands as he was coming straight and forward. And now he's just counterpunching beautifully, catching Nate Campbell with a lot of good shots.
Right, hold on, let him go.
So 3-3, 57-57.
Georgia, because Campbell doesn't really have a polished style, does he waste energy and tire more rapidly than he might otherwise?
I think the energy is muscle tension. You're in with a guy that you've heard a lot about in your weight division. That caused a lot of tension. Ordinarily, you wouldn't jump so far back if you wasn't so afraid of it.
All right, I got it. Stop.
So you're tired because you're hyped up.
Muscle tension. I mean, it just tears you down after a while. But he's keeping the style of getting right on you.
You have to remember, George, for good left hand by
good Casamayor. Counter left.
And for Nate Campbell, this is his Super Bowl.
Whoa,
this
is
the big fight.
Good, good. Don't hit him. Don't roll that elbow.
Now he's gotten back to his hit and run
style. There is now blood coming from along the right, the left eye of Casamayor.
Time.
Below or above?
Time in. Let's go.
And the referee is claiming that was caused by a headbutt as well.
Yep, there's the trickle of blood outside the left eye of Casamayor, as Larry said. Just about in the same position as the right eye cut for Nate Campbell.
Four straight jabs by Campbell.
Tonight is going to be about conditioning. Is Nate Campbell in the condition to go the distance? He's got everything else, but can he keep this up for a few rounds?
Well, I can just hear Nate. He would say to you, it won't be about condition, it'll be about desire. That's how I'm going to win, because I want it so much.
Well, what he said was, when you have nothing left to give, you find something else to give.
Hard right hand to the body by Campbell. Casamayor comes back with a four-punch combination. Well, Casamayor looking more physically in command of his game at this point in round seven.
And yet, this has been a pretty good comeback round for Campbell.
And now that cut is in a bad spot for Campbell, because he loops that right hand around the curve anyway.
Let me have that hand swipe. Take out his mouthpiece.
I got it.
You gotta keep moving, and you gotta let your hands go. You're winning the fight.
All he's gotta do is outwork him. Three rounds.
I got a butt. How's that cut look?
Yeah, you know, Pat, he hit him with an overhand left when he cut him at first. Okay.
You know? See what you can do with that cut, Joe.
Uh-huh. It's already close. It's already stopped loose. Can we have some Vaseline, please?
He doesn't want too much, and you're letting him stay there. You got to finish him. You got to pressure him so he quits. If you pressure him, you're going to stop him. You understand?
You got to do is put it on. You just got to put your balls on.
That's it.
Now Nate Campbell prepares to enter the eighth round of a fight for the fourth time in his 24-fight professional career, which began in the year 2000, just before his 28th birthday. Casamayor, forget it. More than 300 amateur fights, all of the professional experience he's had. He's been the distance 12 rounds many, many times. So the vast experience differential in the late rounds favors Casamayor.
Casamayor waits and hesitates and tries to land the big shot. If he can just let his hands go, close range, he can connect a lot easier than throwing those big punches, and they'll hurt more.
By CompuBox numbers, Casamayor had thrown 99 punches more than Campbell coming into this eighth round. So he has been able to let his hands go in the middle rounds.
I got it. Stop. Break. Step out. Watch your hits.
It's still left jab, right hand for Campbell. His left hook is not apparent except when he is at very close quarters.
Larry, if Campbell fights with bravery and spirit, but loses a decision to the much more credentialed and better technique Casamayor, how big a black mark is that on the Rags to Riches story?
Well, I think it. Everybody says, let's see him again against another quality opponent. He certainly hasn't shown that he's outclassed in this fight.
No, he's in the fight. What he has shown is that it was an ambitious step to take the fight.
You can't blame his management. He's 30 years old. They wanted to see if he was real or a mirage.
Yeah, and when were they going to get another chance like this? Why wait? I agree totally. Go ahead.
You guys wouldn't make good managers, I tell you.
Do you think Campbell is doing this too soon, George?
Look, this guy's got a lot of heart. He's got a lot of style. He stepped up a ladder with a guy who can really punch and keep the pressure on him, who's known to do so. Why do you make a match like this? I don't know.
Well, I'll tell you, the biggest purse that Campbell ever had before this fight was $25,000. Tonight, he's getting $150,000.
Let his head out. There you go.
He's got three daughters, ages 12, 10, and 8. And he said, hey, with this, I'll be able to send them to college. That was his point. But, of course, I'm sure, George, you would say if he had been patient, he might have gotten the same opportunity down the road when he was more well-prepared.
Not only that, but a different style and a different fighter.
I don't believe he can change his style when he started so late into boxing.
I think George is talking about the opponent, Larry. And punches landed per round, and you can see Casamayor's graph went up in the middle of the fight. Campbell has had some busy rounds, such as the sixth, but by and large, since round four, it's been mostly Casamayor's fight.
Right hand is gonna come. So when you throw the right hand, if you don't throw the hook, stay low.
That's okay. Round nine, come on.
Stay low, drink this. Drink that. Listen to me, baby. Listen to me. You got 6 minutes?
I got it.
You need 6 minutes.
I got it.
You need it.
Okay? You need a 6 minute, you understand?
Let's go.
You gotta keep pressuring him. If you pressure him, he won't wanna fight anymore. You gotta show a little bit more to the judges so they can look and see that you're winning.
Round nine, mouthpiece. Mouthpiece.
Words of Joe Goosen to Joel Casamayor as they come out for round nine of a scheduled 10. Second time in his career that Campbell has entered round nine.
I think if Campbell wanted to, he'd gamble a little bit. He can knock Casamayor out if he really wants to. He's hurt him with one shot at a time. Put together four at a time. You can knock him down. He's been afraid to just gamble a little bit. Hit him hard and go for the finish.
I agree. I think if Nate Campbell's going to win the fight, now's the time to go for broke. There's a hard right hand.
And nothing as though he intends to hit him hard and get out of the way. Hit him hard and come right back.
Campbell chasing. Casamayor trying to pick a spot to stop and counter. When Casamayor has followed George Foreman's advice to drive Campbell back into the ropes, he's done well.
It's an easier fight for Casamayor when he fights on the rope. Trouble starts out in the middle.
Campbell still bouncing on his feet. Well into round nine.
Meanwhile, Casamayor hasn't been doing that much in the last couple of rounds.
Another good right hand by Campbell. He just never comes back with his left hook.
Whereas Casamayor countered the right with a two-punch combination.
Whenever you're in a ring, when your fighter starts to bleed, your opponent starts to bleed, it automatically gives you a new courage. And that's what Campbell is getting right now. You see the blood coming down Casamayor's face, and he's getting the tiger in his tank again.
Yep. Casamayor's left eye starting to swell shut. That puts some energy into Campbell's right hand.
All right, I'll get it. Stop punching. Stop. Right. Step out.
You know, if indeed Nate Campbell got the first three rounds from the officials, he is very much still in this fight.
Stop. 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 Don't do that, fellas. Just don't do that.
Close rounds. Not the easiest fight to score. Certainly, you could conceive that the fight is still on the table as they get ready to go to the 10th round 30 seconds from now. Casamayor piling up points now as he drives Campbell back into the ropes with a series of straight left hands. That left hand landed. Campbell shaking his head as if to say no. Usually means yes.
Campbell got smart, started to go down to the body a little bit so he can come up high with that hook.
I thought Campbell won that round.
Yeah, that's how you gotta do it.
I'm not sure.
That's what you have to do.
Give me that towel right there.
You gotta let your hands go. This is one more round. That was another round for you.
He's gotta hit his body.
When you got him up there, look, let your hands go to the body. He doesn't want nothing else. You got him.
This guy doesn't want him.
3 minutes. Can you fight for 3 minutes?
Yes.
All right, let's go.
Nate, we gotta have this round.
You gotta have it, Nate. There's no ifs, ands, or buts about it, baby. We gotta have it.
Understand?
Take.
Okay. You want this one? Let's go take it, baby.
Do you want it?
All right. Let's go take it, baby. You owe it to yourself. You understand?
Last round. You're the champion.
Now, just to continue the drumbeat, Nate Campbell will go into the 10th round for the first time in his professional career. Never been this distance before. Total numbers for CompuBox through round 9. Campbell, 129 out of 422. Casamayor, 149 out of 518. And Casamayor with a brief edge in power punches. Harold, how do you have it through 9?
You know, Jim, somebody busted up Joel Casamayor, and Pat Russell never laid a glove on him. I got it. 5 rounds to 4. 86, 85, Nate Campbell. You know, Jim, he won the first 3 rounds clearly, in my estimation. He came back and had a very good 7th round, and in the 9th round, he just kept letting that right hand go and busted up Casamayor, left him bleeding and swollen. I got very, very close, Campbell by a round.
I'm shocked, Harold. I have the score the same way.
All right, whoa. Step
but
out.
My hunch is,
I'll tell you, judges may shocked. Not. I started to say, I'll tell you who else will be shocked would be Casamayor. Because Casamayor is going to come out of this and think, well, you know, I was so vastly superior to the guy. How could I conceivably have lost?
I don't see that at all. Superior.
He has been the aggressor.
I'm just telling you what I think he'll
turn
think.
Your back,
I'm not
punch
saying
him.
That's true.
Now he's got him if he can just finish him. He allows Campbell to recover.
Whoa. Stop. Break. Good. I'll turn your back.
See, Casamayor believes that he easily won the Freitas fight, which went against him by a narrow unanimous decision.
And he was dead wrong then.
Hard punches.
Campbell loops that right hand just a little enough to go right on the side of Casamayor's face. The left side is swelling up because of it.
Can you imagine how good Nate Campbell might have been if he started when he was 15 instead of 25.
I got it.
I think that's a good age to start boxing, 25.
You do?
Yeah, you don't like to see the young guys finish up so early like that, too many fights. It's a good age, I mean, not the best, but it's a good age.
Well, George, before the fight, you said it all when you said there's no book in boxing.
No book.
Any path that works, right?
That's right. And
you've got to write a new book every time you get in the ring.
You know, and Jim, I commented that this is a Grand Canyon leap of class for Campbell.
It is.
I don't know if he's made it all the way across the canyon, but he's made it a good way across.
It is a good, big leap.
Well, he probably could have jumped the Snake River Canyon with this particular leap, huh?
Stop punching. Finish up.
Hard right hand inside by Casamayor. Both guys trying to punctuate round 10 with statements of their own. I think Joel Casamayor got the better of Campbell in the 10th, but we'll wait and see. Casamayor celebrates as though he's sure of victory, or as if he's trying to convince the judges, and Campbell says, well, hold me up too.
Harold, have you ever done
it?
You're kidding me.
Fear? Look at the next
cassette. Give me the scissor.
Right here.
The three judges here, all from California. Jerry Cantu, Chuck Hassett, David Mendoza, charged with the responsibility now of having chosen a winner between Joel Casamayor and Nate Campbell. And a respectful hug at center ring for the two fighters. Casamayor came in with a record of 28-1, the only loss to Asselino Freitas. Campbell 23-0-0 with 21 KOs. And Michael Buffer knows the answer, so let's find out the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, we go to the scorecards. David Mendoza scores the contest 98-92. Jerry Cantu has it 97-93. And Chuck Hazard scores it 96-94. All three judges scored for the winner by unanimous decision. Joel El Cepillo Casamayor.
So Casamayor impresses the judges enough to get the unanimous decision. Nate Campbell reacts with that curious expression that we commonly see on the faces of fighters who have just lost for the first time in a judge's call that they think goes the wrong way. Casamayor with a 26-punch edge in total landed punches. He threw exactly 100 more punches than Campbell, and that's something Campbell may want to think about later on. Power punches, Casamayor ultimately landing 24 more than Campbell and throwing 126 more. Victory for Casamayor.